This is a pre-built version, so if I go ahead and run it, and let's do a build tree, and the default data set is the weather, and here the best feature to split on is Outlook, and Outlook has three options, either rainy or overcast or sunny, and if it is rainy then the best feature to split on is windy, and there is two options, either windy is true or false, and if it is true then the decision would be to not play outdoors, and if windy is false then the decision would be to play outdoors, and if Outlook is overcast then the decision would be to play outdoors, and if Outlook is sunny then the best feature to split on is humidity, and there is two options, either humidity is normal or it is high, and if it is normal then the decision would be to play outdoors, and if it is high it is to not play outdoors. So let's choose a different data set, and we only have two options, either the weather or the contact lenses data set. Build tree, and so this is the best feature to split on, tier prod rate, and here we have two options, either normal or reduced, and if it is reduced then there would not be a prescription, and if it is normal then the best feature to split on is astigmatism, and this has two options, either no or yes, and if it is no then the best feature to split on is age, and if it is yes then the best feature to split on is this one, spectacle, prescription, etc. Start by creating a new project. And here we will have four classes, a class that represents the data set, and one that represents a feature in that data set, and one that represents one of the values of a feature, and an application driver class with a main method. Now this is the weather and the contact lenses data. And this is the code for the feature value. So it will have a name and a number of occurrences of that feature value, and a get method for the name, and a get and set method for the number of occurrences. And since we will be comparing a feature value against other feature values, then we will have a hash code and an equals method. And the toString method will return the name of that feature value. And we will have a constructor that initializes the name. Now this should do it for this class. Now the feature will have a name and a set of feature values, and get method for the name and the set of feature values, and the toString method will return the name of this feature, and the constructor will take in the column number that this feature represents, and a two-dimensional array for the data in the data set. And we will initialize the name and all the feature values, and we will calculate and set the occurrences of each one of the feature values. Now the data set will have a name and a two-dimensional string array representing the data in this data set, and the calculated entropy for this data set, and a map containing the information gain for each one of the features in this data set, and the best split on feature. And we will have get methods, and the toString method will return the name of this data set, and we will have those two helper methods, this one for deleting a column in a matrix, meaning a two-dimensional string array here, and this one will return the column number given the column name. And this one will calculate the minus p log base 2 and return the calculated value. And we will have a constructor that initializes the name and the data in this data set. And we'll have this method that calculates the entropy for this data set, and this method creates and returns a new data set given a passed in data and a feature and a feature value within that feature. And this one will calculate the information gain for each one of the features in the data set, and this method will find the best split on feature. And we will call those three methods from the constructor: the calculate entropy, and the calculate information gain, and the find split on feature. This should do it for this class. Now the driver class will have a map containing the data sets that can be used in this application. And we will initially pick the first item in the map to use in the application. And since we will be displaying the decision tree in a swing window, we will extend from JFrame. Those two methods will do the work for this application. And we will be calling them from main. Now the decision tree will be displayed in a jtree, and here we are prompting the user if they want to build the decision tree or to choose the data set, which would be one of the data sets that are available in the map. And if they want to choose the data set, we'll prompt the user to pick the data set from the ones that are displayed. And if they don't enter a valid data set, we'll give them this message. Otherwise, the data key will contain the key of the data set that the user have chosen. And if the user has selected to build the tree, then we create a data set given the data key, which will end up being the name of that data set, and the two-dimensional string array for the data in that data set. And the first node in the tree will be what's returned from get split on feature, would be the name of that split on feature for the data set. And then we call process data set, which would build the decision tree. And this code is to display the tree in the swing window. Now for the process dataset method, we actually have two methods. So this one will process the dataset and will end up calling process data sets with an S, which is this method. And this one in turn will end up calling the process data set. So here for each feature value, for the split on feature, we create a new data set and put it in the feature data sets. And in the map, this would be the name, would be the key for each one of the new data sets. And the call to process data sets will have this populated feature data sets, this map, and we'll have the node that was originally passed here. So we do all of this if the entropy is different than zero for the data set, which means we are not at a leaf node. So this code is when we are at a leaf node. And in this case, we will add the decision to play or not to play to that leaf node. And here, for each data set, we go ahead and create a new node and add it to the original node, and then call process data set on that new node. Now, if the entropy is zero on any one of the data sets, then we don't create a new node and add it to the original node. We call process data set right away, passing in the original node. Finally, let's go ahead and test run the application. Different data set.